So fifth dimension is not a place. It's not a utopian place. It's just, again, it's your perception, it's your imagination of an image you would like to support, and you would like, and that's planted in your mind too. You've been brainwashed, spiritual brainwashed. It's another form of brainwash. So you can't become free. To get free, you have to go beyond all of it. You have to reject everything. All ideas, all concepts. Because all these concepts and these ideas are thought forms. They're thoughts. Being a slave in slavery of your mind. It's much easier to control minds than to control the bodies. Controlling bodies cost money. There's resistance because there has to be concentration camps, or there have to be structural camps, something that you're forced to do, to be there and do this. It's so much easier to control your mind, so you're willingly doing things. So if you want freedom, don't look outside in the world, because the ones you're looking for, they don't have a clue. They're lost too. They can't create freedom for you by creating a utopian world. They're stuck too. You gotta go beyond your mind. It's an inside job. Internally, become free. Free from all thoughts, holy thoughts or dark thoughts, it doesn't matter. No thoughts. Into silence. Freedom from all thoughts by exercising what you have inherited from the time you were born. And you dive back into that place. You turn towards the source. And you dive in. And in that, you hit something, and then all of a sudden, peace comes, and bliss becomes your reality of the moment. And you have entered into your fifth, into the fifth dimension. It has nothing to do with the outside world. And to your surprise, you may discover you're still driving your Tesla and you're still having your second house in Spain and you still have your savings. But you're not looking for them to bring you comfort, because they don't bring you comfort. They stress you out. Because you're trying to figure out how to save them. You've discovered something far, far more deeper. Far, far more with value. No one can ever take it from you. You can be imprisoned, tortured, beaten up, raped, killed, everything, and it's still there. And the good news is you can do it. Because there have been people before you who have done it. And that's great relief. And you're touching it. When we come together and we dive into silence, I know in my heart that you're touching it. I know in my heart you're getting a glimpse of it. And that happens through meditation. It happens through tantra sexuality. When you're making love to your partner and it's a tantric make love, you dive into that place. That's why sex is such a dangerous thing. And it has to be shameful and associated to guilt and fear and must be driven, pushed to go underground and turn into wicked ways. That's why, because it's one of the most powerful ways to reach fifth-dimensional self through tantric sexuality. So it was very quickly identified as the pathway to awakening. So it got shut down very fast. And guess what they do to you from your childhood? What they tell you? It's so deeply rooted in you that you're even afraid to talk about it. You don't even bring the word. And if I bring the word, you just get uncomfortable and start moving around. Yet, most of your life, you've been thinking about it. You've been dreaming about it. Even if you've been married and in love with one person, you think about it with other people. You know what I'm talking about. That's a one. There are other ways. There's substances that also help you get a glimpse of the fifth dimensional self. There's different ways. It happens sometimes at childbirth. A mother is giving birth, and in that extreme pain and intensity of the labor, she taps into silence. She taps into this other higher dimension of herself, which is pure, it's silent, it's blissful. There's nothing there, it's just is. I'm sure some of you who've given birth have experienced that. Not everybody, but some do. I can't say I have.